The original Shimano TX7s were thought to be quite exceptional. But let me tell you this, the new ones are even better. Looks as I've hit the prayer mat, but what I can tell you is many anglers have worshipped at the shrine of Shimano's original TX7 rods. They were absolutely fabulous, and I couldn't find anybody with a bad word to say about them. But Shimano, in their infinite wisdom, have produced these. These are the new TX7's A's, and they have been upgraded in quite a few places. The carbon's been upgraded, it's a little bit stiffer through this back section. There's a lot of power in these rods. Fabulous lightweight Kaigan guides, good as you can get. A beautiful flared bit on the end of the Japanese shrink-wrapped handle that really lets you grip the rod. So if you give it a whack, it's not flying out of your hand. And upgraded Fuji reel seats provide what is an astonishing looking rod. The model that Shimano have sent me is their Intensity. Got 3.5 pound plus test curve. And I think the plus is a variable because I have never seen a blank so slim with so much power. How they've crammed that much energy. Oops. How they've crammed that much energy into something so slim is an absolute mystery to me. And as a, you know, as a professional tackle editor, I've seen a lot of rods, but never have I seen anything with this sort of energy in it. Now, I'm not supposed to make mistakes, but I'll tell you this, I came here with these rods thinking, been to Naesby a few times, not that difficult. I didn't come with the kit I needed because these rods almost beg you to give them a bit of stick. I didn't bring big enough leads. It's super windy here. The fish live out there or out there. They're not exactly, you know, they're not exactly swimming around in the margin. And I didn't bring heavy enough leads, and neither did I bring sort of the right sort of line on the reels. But now I've come back and I've got some heavier leads, and I haven't started on that heavier leads here. I've started with sort of 3.5, but I'm gonna go up to 4 and even 4.5 ounce leads because this tiny little blank wants more lead on it. As for casting distance wise, I suppose a lot of that depends on, it does depend on your build, your skill set, and your casting ability. I'm not very big, I'm about 5'9", and I know sort of my parameters. If I'm hitting sort of 30 wraps, I'm really happy. I have no doubt that this rod is capable of a lot more than that, but not in my hands. Probably someone that's a little bit bigger, because the longer limbs you've got, you know, the faster you can hit it. There are people that are not so big that can cast very well, but I think that, you know, you should know your own parameters. But one thing is for sure, because you might think, well, what the hell do you need a cast? You know, a distance casting rod, and that's what these are, if that's what you're saying. The facts are, you still need to be able to put a heavy lead quite a long way on venues like this, and you're simply not gonna do that unless you've got something that's got the energy and the intrinsic power that a rod like this possesses. Sun's gone in, it's got a bit colder, but the wind has just got ridiculous, and I am struggling to keep a straight line between the lead hitting the water and the rod. And what I need is a bigger lead. So we're going up from 3.5 to 4. And if that don't work, we're gonna go to 5. But I have every belief that that rod there, even with a stringer on it and a snowman, will propel this like a cat out of hell. So before I propel the lead and that bag out there, just point out how high this rod's loading point is. And the loading point is where it picks up the weight of the object that you're casting. You can see it there. It's probably between the tip and the penultimate guide. And that's probably where I expect it to be. They do vary slightly casting rods, but make no mistake about it, that's very high and ideal for casting. Right. Well, it didn't feel much difference from 4 ounces and 3.5, or even, it did feel a little bit different from the 3, but I have straightened my line a little bit on the cast, because you may, it probably doesn't pick it up on the film, but it is so windy, it's very, very difficult. But a casting rod like this, this is a rod that you need to be with. The more you fish with this rod, the better it's gonna be. That's exactly how I feel about it. I don't know how many casts I've had today and last time I took it out, but you can bet your life it's probably not more than 15 casts. So it's a slow process, but already I'm building up to heavier leads. Anything I've asked of it, you know, I'm not going ridiculous distance, but a fair distance, you know. It's performing admirably, and I still think that there's a lot more left, and the power this thing produces is just nonsensical for something that's so slim. Now, before I put this down on the alarms, one of the reasons need to be pointed out about distance rods, and we've dealt with the hide loading, but when you compress and then it decompresses, or actually, you know, it throws the lead out, it's all about tip speed, and I won't bother to talk about casting because, you know, we all cast slightly differently. But what the rod needs to do to help me is, once the release is there, the tip needs to stop like that. The tip recovery speed needs to be incredibly quick, and it couldn't be any quicker than it is. This rod is very, very crisp. Most distance casting rods are, but it's a sure sign that it's made of a quality material when it does basically that and stops dead once the lead has been released. If it's doing that and moving around, it just slows the cast. So you want that quick tip recovery speed. Now, whether you're a seasoned pro long-time carper or just getting into long-range angling, this reel is simply to die for. It is a top-end reel, and this is Shimano's new Power Aero 1400 XDC. It's got more features than a jet fighter. At some of the very special things that it does have, they've slowed the oscillation down slightly, and that's the amount of times, the one oscillation is the amount of times that the bail arm goes round the spool as it travels up and down, to about 50. I think that's a good thing for Shimano, because I think, like, the old mags were a little bit too slow on the oscillation for me and a little bit difficult to fish with at times. But this reel, absolutely bang on. Now, it's got something called, I think it's called silent drive. And basically, when the reel is under a lot of pressure, whether you're winding in big, heavy, you know, leads, or you're playing big fish, it's really silent to, you know, in its performance. Now, that might sound a bit of a strange thing to be excited about, but carp reels invariably get a lot of grief and a lot of stick, and they're out in all weathers and they get a bit squeaky sometimes, but this thing runs beautifully, quietly. 4.3 gear ratio, which is quite good. It's Hagen cold forged gears, which Shimano have been using quite some time, but a proven quality of design there. Parallel body, it's super sleek to look at. And yeah, if you're in your bivvy staring out at them, even if you're doing a week or longer, you wouldn't be disappointed. Personally, I really like the wider spool. I've only got little fingers, I'm not a very big guy, and I find that the shorter spools are much easier for me to cast with, especially if I'm going to give it a whack if I've got a finger stall on as well. So for me, I really like the wider spool. And also, a lot of waters you go to now, and they want you to use like 15 pound line, and it's also braid friendly reel, by the way, but 15 pound line, if you've got like a long cone nose reel, it can be a little bit difficult and get twisted up a little bit. But this, absolutely perfect. It does come with a spare spool, and it also comes with Shimano's spool fillers, you know, so you don't have to put too much line on it. You can please yourself what you do with it. But all in all, that is an absolute Brahma of a reel. And I can't think of a single angler or a carp angler that wouldn't want one of them. You're not, even if you're not doing that much distance fishing, it is just a thing of beauty. I have had chance to look at every aspect of these rods, other than the thing that's happening now, which is their play in action. I've gone through most of the lead sizes now, and it's performed admirably. In fact, it can perform better than I can. But this is the all important bit. Not fishing with the biggest hooks ever. I'm fishing with an 8. And we've had a run, and I want to see this action. And I'm looking at it straight down the blank, and there's a bit of play up there. I mean, obviously this is a super powerful rod. You know, this would do you for France and many places, but the fish in this reservoir are not tame creatures. They are angry and they're very mean, even the small ones. And I have to say, at the moment, I quite like that. It was never going to be soft. It's not, it doesn't want to be soft. It won't work if it's soft. So you're never going to get it being particularly progressive, because it knows it needs to load the weight quite high for the casting distance. But look, you know, you don't need a broom handle, and that is not a broom handle. It's a long way from it. Now, the fish is still a little ways out, and luckily here at Naesby, we can wade a little bit, and I don't want him to cross my other rod, so we'll go out a little bit further. And like all fish playing circumstances, whether it be carp or, you know, feeder rods or anything else, the proof of the real pudding, the real tasty bit, will be when it gets under my feet. Now, just if I can hang on to my landing net, it'll be handy. Well, this is the moment then, you know, because it could be a, it's not going to be a PB, but it could well be, you know, there could be a scenario where that happens. It is a lot of fun with the wind here, but we're getting there. We're getting there. And that's not a bad fish. Over the string she comes, and we're in.
Yay!
What an absolute beauty and a real brute of a fish from Naesby. And only carpers would know this moment. This has been a very hard won fish, and I'm absolutely wowed with that. I'm also wowed with Shimano's new TX7A rods. They are very, very different. And you know, you get something and you're not sure about it, but you know long term you're going to love it. That's how I feel about these rods. I fish with them twice. I want to fish with them again. It's a learning curve with these rods. I don't think you can go in the shop, go out fishing with it and go, oh, it's absolutely incredible. You're going to have to learn how to fish with that rod. But the rewards, what more can I say, are there.